We continue with Parish President Robby Miller at the big giveaway of school supplies in Punchatoula at Kiwanis Park. The Kiwanis Club partnering with Sisters Serving Sisters. And it just reminds me, Robby, I know you were at the big event in Hammond yesterday. We have so many great back-to-school events, and it just makes you feel proud to see what we as a community are doing for young people.
Ken, and absolutely no doubt about it. Whenever I say we're the best parish in the state, 99% of it's about our people. And look, it's not, you have the Kiwanis here in Punchatoula with Sisters and Sisters, making sure Punchatoula's covered. Hammond City and the Hammond City Court, our 7th Ward Court, yesterday in Hammond. There's churches up and down the parish that are making sure our students are ready for school. Our school system has made significant changes, improvements over the last couple of few years. We're moving in the right direction. So everything about our parish really makes us the best parish in the state, that everybody's pulling together to make sure that our children are ready and that our parish is going to be ready.
Well, it's just this sense of community that we're all in this together, and that is so rare these days across the nation.
Well, Kent, you're right, but it talks about Tangipahoa. Like I said, we move here. When we need to do something, we move and we take care of it. And look, there's diversity up and down that line. Everybody's getting along. They're talking. The crowd's here helping everybody. It's just great to see all of us come together, and there's none of that junk you see all over the national news and all that here. We all love each other, we help take care of each other, and we get along. Are we perfect? Heck no. But we understand each other, and we want everybody to have their best and be their best.
Well, knock on wood, juvenile crime is down if you just go by the court dockets. It just looks as though everybody's working together to have a very successful start to the school year.
Well, that's what I'm saying, too. I believe that's the truth. It looks like it. Our adults get along. Our adults work hard together. We have our discussions to vet out any differences, to try and come up with a better solution, not just to be against something, but to say, how do we make it better? Donna talks about people with differing opinions triangulate and put their problem out in front and say, we're gonna address the problem with our differences of opinions, and let's get the best solution for it. So it looks like we do that a lot more here in our parish than I see almost anywhere else, definitely across the country. But I think that we need to pay attention to our local news, we need to pay attention to our local way of life, and we're doing it pretty well. We have to get better, but we're doing it pretty well.
Well, in the meantime, this is a Saturday when we're speaking, and the grass cutters are obviously out in force. This has to be the most active time for grass growing, so it's reassuring the parish has the grass cutters. But therein hangs a tale. You've had some real problems with all the hurricane debris still around. It's been tough.
It has. Our guys have really worked hard to do the best they can to keep up. We haven't always been caught up. I think we're pretty close right now, but it's because they're working 6 days a week, 10 hours a day. And it's coming around. We're doing some things to try and help, too, with some spraying now to stunt the grass. We're on a kind of a normal routine, a rotation, I should say. But, whenever it rains a half a day, it stops us from cutting, and then the grass is watered, so it's more robust. But overall, we're working hard. We have a lot of roadwork going on. We have a lot of construction projects going on. We have more coming. We're working very hard on making sure we're ready for the infrastructure money, the IIJA money that's coming out of the federal government. I think we're going to see a lot of activity over the next few years in Tangipahoa Parish for sure.
But you had to get some extra mowers and some extra motors.
Well, we're working on it. The problem is we could order them today and they take, short term is 6 months, more like a year. So we're actually working on potential some contract folks to help us out if we need to. But our guys are working hard. They're giving their extra effort to catch us up.
On the subject of debris, where do we stand?
We're pretty much done. They're only picking up the stumps that are out there. Some of the stumps are having to bust up on site, at the site they are, and then load them up. They're steadily getting those done. And then we have the private property access, the criteria. Our monitor, Tetra Tech, went out and worked with a whole list of folks, and they're working through that process. There's a lot of paperwork, a lot of evaluation, a lot of approvals that have to happen before we can go do that, though.
But there'll be debris in the woods forever. And the drainage laterals are being cleared, but that's going to take a while.
It is, and quite frankly, we don't have enough money yet to get them all done, but we have a good bit of dollars from the federal government, the drainage district, and the parish, and we're working, have contractors working those, I'll say critical, the ones that move more water out and are the larger tributaries getting water to the river first, and then we'll go out from there. And we're constantly asking for more money to keep going and do more and more. But you're right, there's a lot of debris that we'll never know about.
You know, before I came here, I was with Judge Britton Sledge at his family farm, and the reason he's there is because he's not yet back in his house because of Ida damage. You're not back in your house yet. I know that David Vial on the parish council, he's not back in his house yet, or just got back in. I could list some other people I know, friends of mine, that are also still not back in their homes. So we like that we're back to normal, but that we bounce back this fast from a hurricane, it's a double-edged thing, isn't it?
Well, it goes back to our citizens really pulling together to help each other out. And we have a lot of great contractors. We had contractors come in from out of state, out of town. But our folks really pulled together to make sure that our citizens were back as quick as possible. Not all of us are whole yet, but our lives are pretty close to normal.
However, there's still people out there suffering. Not that I'd put you in that category, but on the other hand, you know, not being in your house is pretty bad.
It can be trying sometimes, but overall, we're very fortunate that we have a place in Hammond, a little apartment in Hammond that's working out well for us, so we're doing okay. There are folks who need a little more help than that, and hopefully, look, we have nonprofits that are here still looking, asking us who needs help, so we need to know who those people are. You know, sometimes they're hard to find, some of those folks don't know, so if you know somebody who's needing help and who doesn't know where to go, call us, and we will do all we can to match them up with the right resources to do the best to get them back on their feet.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, yeah, school's about to start. It's going to be an exciting time. Traffic's going to pick up because of that. So let's be patient. Leave earlier. Make sure that, enjoy the time that we have school. Be excited about that. I think it's a great time of year. Football season's about to start. Best time. That's actually the best time of the year. And then, really help take care of each other. We do that well, so let's continue to do that.